Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good morning. We are from group 2 and we would like to present our material that is critical analysis and the rhetoric of critic. Firstly, let me introduce our member. My name is Yevunia Limebrianti as the moderator and the last speaker. The first speaker is Muhammad Muksan Santoso and the second speaker is Gabriela Adelia. So let's start our first material. For Muhammad Muksan Santoso, time is yours.
Okay, thank you. I will explain about the what is critical discourse analysis. Critical discourse analysis, or CDA, is an interdisciplinary approach to the study of discourse, or put simply, thought and text, that views language as a form of social practice. Scholars working in the tradition of CDA generally argue that non-linguistic social practice and linguistic practice constitute one another and focus on investigating how societal powers relations are established and reinforced through language use. In this sense, it differs from discourse analysis or discourse analysis in that it highlights issues of power asymmetries, manipulation, exploitation, and structural inequalities in dominant domains such as education, media, and politics. According to Brees, 2011, critical discourse analysis is now firmly established itself as a field within the humanities and social science, to the extent that the abbreviation CDA is widely used to denote a recognizable approach to language studies manifest across a range of different groups. Indeed, some scholars have even suggested that critical discourse analysis is close to becoming an intellectual orthodoxy, an institutionalized discipline with its own paradigm, in own canon and conventionalized assumptions, and even its our power structures, since CDA is now part of the intellectual landscape. There is a certain tendency for it to be taken for granted, simply accepted as a valid way of thinking and researching alongside the other paradigms that have attained intellectual respectability. Okay, I think that's all. Thank you. Back to you.
Thank you, Dimas. Next, we move to the next slide for Gabriela Adelia. Time is yours.
Okay, thank you. I will explain about critical studies. The emergence of critical discourse analysis has occurred at a time that coincides with the role of other critical paradigms such as critical psychology, critical social policy, and critical anthropology. As has been mentioned, critical discourse analysis initially had an alternative labels such as critical language awareness or critical language studies. According to Faircloth, also used the label critical linguistic. In this context, the term critical can be seen to mark out a specific genre of academic studies, and one can ask what implications are carried by this label. More specifically, it is possible to identify several crucial features which the recent critical paradigms or theories or disciplines claim to possess and which give particular meaning to the current use of critical. The first and most important factor is the critical approaches claim to be critical of the present social order. Critical discourse analysis, like critical psychology or critical social policy, is critical because it is rooted in the radical critique of social relations. The second, following from the commitment to radical critique, critical approaches position themselves as being critical of other academic approaches that are not primarily addressed to the critique of existing patterns of dominance and inequality. The third, critical approaches assert the academic work is related to the social condition of dominations. It is argued that non-critical approaches tend to constitute the dominant position within particular academic disciplines. Okay, I think that's all. Thank you.
Thank you, Gabriela Adelia. Now, we back to Muhammad Rohmat Muksan Santoso. Time is yours.
Okay, thank you. Okay, next, I will explain about the social context of academic work. The analysis of power relations, which is central for a critical approach, starts close to home. The critique of the non-critical paradigms is also typically an analysis of the power relations within the academic context. For the non-critical And this is not mentioned in order to downgrade the importance of critical approaches to the study and of contemporary discourse. Quite the reverse, it follows from the assumption that the critical approach must seek to place the analysis of particular discursive formations in a wider social context, particularly an academic context. In this regard, it must be acknowledged that critical academic endeavors operate in the same broad economic context as uncritical approaches. If the context affects the nature of discourse, then one must expect critical and non-critical approaches to share common rhetorics. Certainly, critical texts tend to bear the hallmarks of conventional contemporary academic writing. Okay, I think that's all. Back to you, Mibri. Thank you.
Thank you, Dimas. And the last material will be explained by me about the dilemmas on success. According to Weiss and Wodak 2007, if the success of an endeavor such as a critical discourse analysis must occur within an academic context of a power and economic relations, then this is not a matter of good or bad intention by the critical analyst. However, it's all too easy for critical analysts in their critics of the mainstream other to ignore, to indeed wish away this aspect of their endeavors. Dilemmas affect not only the teaching of a critical perspective, but also the establishment of the perspective as a research activity. As critical paradigm establishes itself, so it takes on many of the characteristics of an established discipline. Okay, that's all from our group. Thank you for attention. Bye.
Bye, thank you.